is a frequently asked question in Module 2 of your Probability and Statistics course. Given the sample data, find the range, the mean, the variance, and the standard deviation. Here is the sample data that we're given. Now, to find the range, it's simply the maximum minus the minimum. So here, 23 is the maximum, 12 is the minimum, so that's just 11. Now, these other statistics, the mean, the variance, and standard deviation, can be found using the calculator. So I'd like to show you an easy way to do this type of problem using the calculator. Let me walk you through this very briefly. So you'll go to your stat button and leave it on edit, hit enter. Enter all of the data in list 1. Hit stat again, go over to calculate, leave it on one variable stat, hit calculate, and here we have a list of various symbols, and the first symbol is pronounced X bar, which stands for the mean. So the first thing I'm going to write down is the mean that I have here. And that turns out to be 16.9. Let me get that back. 16.9. And the variance is not actually listed here under one variable stats. Instead, what we have to do is find the standard deviation. Since it's sample data, we use this one, S sub X, and I'm going to actually keep several digits after the decimal to avoid rounding error. So I'm going to write down the sample standard deviation, and that is 3.21282, and you could keep going, but the important thing to remember is to keep at least 5 digits after the decimal to avoid rounding error, because what we're about to do is take this and square it to find the variance. So I'm going to go ahead and do 3.21282 squared and hit enter, and that's going to be the variance. So I'm going to do 10.3222 and so on. Now, we're asked to round to certain place values. So I'd like to go over this place value chart very quickly and just remind you of how to round. If you're asked to round to the tenth place, you look to the right of the tenth place. If it's 5 or more, you go up. If you're asked to round to the hundredth place, then you look to the thousandth place. If it's 5 or more, you go up to the next whole number. So here on this problem, we were asked to round to the tenth place for the mean. Well, that's already there. That's the tenth place. This one we're asked to round to the hundredth place. So that means I'm going to look to the thousandth place value. Here it's a 2. It's not 5 or bigger. So I'm going to leave this alone, and the answer is going to be 10.32. And on the standard deviation, we're asked to round to the tenth place. So I look to the hundredth place value, and it's not 5 or bigger. So I'm going to leave this alone, and this is actually 3.2. So when you're working these problems, if you're asked to find the variance first, just know that you're going to use the standard deviation on the calculator, square it, keep several digits, at least 5 digits after the decimal, before you square it to avoid rounding error. And then you can round the variance to the appropriate place value. I hope this example helps. Good luck, everyone.